bacterial cell is a prokaryocyte. It is devoid of nucleolus, nuclear membrane, and a single molecule of double-stranded DNA, and there is an extra chromosome resulting material called plasmid, which gives survival advantages of drug resistance and toxicity. Now coming to the bacterial cell proper, this is a cell wall of bacteria which is made up of N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muriatic acid, and gram-positive cell wall is 40 times thicker than gram-negative cell wall, and it has periplasmic lipoid layer. That's why all gram-negative bacteria are resistant to commonly used antibiotics. Now there is an organ of locomotion which is called flagella. It is flagellin. Depending on the arrangement of flagella, bacteria are classified as eutrachate. All examples, all cocci are eutrachate, monotrachate, single flagellum at one end, peritrachate, all enteric organisms are the example of peritrachate organism, and monotrachate, Vibrio cholerae, amphitrachate, Pseudomonas, a single flagellum at both end, tuft of flagellum at one end and both end, that is spirillum. So it's made up of flagellin and it gives rise to flagellar antigen called flagellin. Now there is a small hair-like structures which arises from the cell wall. These are called pili or fimbriae, and which is made up of which are protein in nature, and they are also antigenic. They help in the antigenicity of bacterial cell. They produces a gummy substance called adhesins through which they attach to the mucous membrane of the human, especially in gonococci. Now there is a sex fimbria or pili which conjugate with the male fimbria, conjugate with female fimbria in the process of conjugation. So through which it's also called as extraction. Extra chromosomal genetic material is passed from one bacteria to another bacteria. So cytoplasm is a colloidal material which contains inorganic and organic solutes, and it has got inclusion bodies, proteins, carbohydrates and lipid. A special inclusion body helps in the identification of bacteria, that is called as polymetachromatic granules, Golgi granules, Graves' Ernest granules. They are also polar granules because they are situated at the poles. Now coming to, there is one more cover outside the cell wall. If it is not well formed, it is called a loose slime or slime layer, and if it is well formed, it is a capsule. So bacteria in hostile conditions, they undergo what is called as sporulation. Sporulation is not a process of reproduction, it's a bomb shelter for bacteria. Spores are high resistant, dormant resting stage of bacteria. One spore gives rise to one bacteria. There are example of sporulating organisms are Bacillus forms spores in presence of oxygen, Clostridium forms spores in absence of oxygen. Now moving on to the spore capsule. Example of capsulate organism are pneumococci, anthrax. Now flagella, fimbria, cell wall, and cytoplasmic membrane, unit membrane, which helps in the binary fissions, and there is the invagination from cytoplasmic membrane. These are called mesosomes. They contain respiratory enzyme. They are the lungs of bacteria. Coming inside, there is a nucleus, which looks like a sponge, and when you stretch it, it is 1,000 microns in length. It contains single molecule of double-stranded DNA. There is extra chromosomal genetic material called plasmid, which gives additional advantage of drug resistance and toxicity. This is in brief morphology of bacterial cell. The prokaryocyte lacks mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, and it is a very primitive cells compared to human cells and fungal cells.